If you're wondering what it looks like to work from home as a cybersecurity analyst, I would definitely urge you to watch this video to the end, because I will be taking you through a typical day in my life working remotely as a cybersecurity analyst, starting from checking my emails for alerts down to investigating potential threats such as phishing emails and brute force attacks. You will get an inside look of the tools that I use and how I keep systems safe from the comfort of my home. So, let's dive in. What I do first is always check my emails for any new alerts or if any task has been assigned to me. As you know, staying on top of these notifications is essential to prevent any potential security breach. As you can see here, we've got a high severity alert. And I would also walk you through how I investigate this alert and how I respond to it. We've got a low severity alert, and the description says this email has been reported by a user as a malware or a phishing email. I would walk you through the steps on how I also investigate this low severity alert. Now that I have checked my email to see what alert I need to investigate, the next thing is to come over to my dashboard, and what I use is Microsoft Sentinel. Microsoft Sentinel is basically a combination of a SIEM and a SOAR, so that is security, information, event management, and with that, I can analyze and parse logs from various connectors, such as Entra ID, Microsoft Defender, Threat Intelligence, and with SOAR, it's security, orchestration, automation, response. And basically I can create a nice, you know, automate flows to basically respond to an alert automatically. And you can do nice stuff with that. Just to show you what a data connector looks like, this is an example of a data connector. As you can see, I've got Azure Activity, Microsoft Defender for Cloud, Defender for Endpoint, Entra ID. And what this does is that it gets the logs from all these connectors, and then it brings it over to the dashboard here. And here, I can have like an overview of what's going on, how many alerts, incidents, and you know what I need to respond to. Now that we understand what the dashboard is about, I would like to ask, if you were in my position, which of these incidents would you investigate first? Would you rather investigate the low severity alert first, or would you investigate the high severity alert? I would say it's always good to, you know, investigate or start with the high severity alert. And the reason is because the potential or the probability that this low severity alert is a false positive is usually high. And then the probability that this high severity alert would cause potential damage is also high. So it's always good to, you know, investigate or start with this high severity alert. But for the sake of this video, I would like to start with a low severity alert, and then we can take it further to these high severity alerts. Let's take a closer look at this reported email. We've got 10 entities here, and basically entities are everything that makes up this alert. So starting from the sender down to any suspicious link, as you can see, we've got one here, to the malicious IP address. And we can start first by investigating this IP address. We can have some insights because Microsoft Sentinel also has this sandbox connected, such as virus tutor. It says it's a malicious URL, and then the criminal IP address. It has also been reported by two sources. So this tells me that I need to investigate this further in the Microsoft XDR. You might want to ask me, why am I using Microsoft XDR, or also known as Microsoft Defender, to further investigate this attack, and why not just continue with Microsoft Sentinel? The reason is that Microsoft Defender, or XDR, primarily targets the end user environment, which includes the endpoints, identities, email, and cloud applications. Now that we understand my main reason for using Microsoft XDR, I want to further investigate this email by reading the actual body. And if I click on this explorer, here I can look for the email. And if I click on license and update, it should open this email body for me, and then I can, you know, have a better understanding. This doesn't look like the actual Microsoft licensing link, so it is suspicious. And what I'm gonna do next is just to copy this URL and then see for myself if it is true. Yeah, it says dangerous. Dangerous site. It says it all. It is suspicious. And next thing I want to do is just block the IP address, delete the email. This is the IP address here. So this is the IP address. I can come down here to settings. And if I go to endpoint, under indicators, yeah, I'll put an IP address. I can also copy the URL and then, yeah. So once I'm done with this, block it off, and then I'm just gonna do, give a detailed explanation on what went wrong and my whole process of analyzing this email. And yeah, I'm done with that. Next is to go ahead and then investigate the brute force attack. I also need to put this right here as resolved, and then I give my explanation why, and then I can put phishing and then save. That's done. Also, once I'm done with investigating this alert, I also try to create nice dashboards or automations. And basically, automations are just like, for example, it's a playbook, and I can show you some templates here. I also created some automation rules myself. I've got some active playbooks here. For example, this automation here sends email to the infected user. So if a user has been breached, receive an email directly. And it could be anything. It could be also receive an email to resolve low severity alerts. And then it gives me the opportunity to investigate or focus on other high severity alerts. I also have stand-up meetings. Let's come together and then we see what we've been doing so far. For example, what I have investigated and what I believe we should do to reduce, let's say, for example, the phishing attack or the brute force attack. Yes, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I would appreciate if you can like, share, and comment. Also, subscribe. Very important. That would motivate me to make more videos. Thank you, and have a beautiful day.